نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أفلا يتدبرون القرآن ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا صدق الله العظيم. Respect listeners, Alhamdulillah, till now we've been listening to many of our great scholars mentioning the virtues of the Holy Quran. Alhamdulillah, I've just come from Khatm Quran Mahfil Al-Mahadul Islami in Bradford, and after half an hour I have to go to Bradford again to Jamia Khatum Nabeen for the third Khatm Quran. So amazing that today in one day we're having three Khatm Qurans within Bradford. This is the beauty of this Holy Quran. It's a miracle. When this Quran, like mashallah, one of our great speakers, he was saying about the beauty of this Quran, that the challenges that were faced, like Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam time, sorcery, black magic, all these things were rampant and they were rife in the society. So at that time what happened was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam the miraculous staff which transformed into a snake, and it completely overpowered all the magic that they did. At the time of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, medical science, they were to the highest level. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the miracle to Sayyidina Isa alayhi salatu wasalam to overcome that. He could heal the lepers, he could restore the eyesight of those people who were born blind. The time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, poetry that was rife in the society, a kitab called As-Sab'ul Mu'allaqat, it was hung on the door of the Kaaba. And what happened was people said, can you bring something similar to this? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent this Quran, and he said, قُلْ لَإِنِ اجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنْسُ وَالْجِنُ عَلَىٰ أَن يَأْتُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لَا يَأْتُونَ بِمِثْلِهِ وَلَوْ كَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ ظَهِيرًا. If all the mankind, the jinn kind, they all gathered to produce something like of the Holy Quran, لَا يَأْتُونَ بِمِثْلِهِ, they will not be able to produce something like it. وَلَوْ كَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ ظَهِيرًا, even though they come together. When this challenge was hard, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the challenge even easier. He said, أَمْ يَقُولُونَ افْتَرَى قُلْ فَأْتُوا بِعَشْرِ سُوَرٍ. If you say that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, na'udhu billahi, is fabricated, concocted this Quran, then bring 10 surahs. Then he came to قُلْ فَأْتُوا بِسُوَرٍ, bring 3 surahs. At the end, when they couldn't do this, وَإِنْ كُنْتُمْ فِي رَيْبٍ مِمَّا نَزَّلْنَا عَلَىٰ عَبْدِنَا فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِنْ مِثْلِهِ وَدْعُوا شُهَدَاءَكُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. That if you are in doubt regarding what we have revealed to our servant, Ayy Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then bring one surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he concludes the debate, the challenge, by saying, فَإِن لَمْ تَفَعَلُوا وَلَنْ تَفَعَلُوا. If you can't do it, you'll never be able to do it. You'll never. So now till 1400 years has passed by, anybody could just say, okay, I'm going to get that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala closed that chapter. And nobody till today, and nobody till the day of judgment, will be able to bring anything like the suratul, like a surah in the Quran. The shortest surah, suratul Kawthar. Suratul Kawthar has 12 words, 42 letters. Allahu Akbar. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, bring something the size of suratul Kawthar. But nobody till today and nobody till the day of judgment will be able to bring something like this. So this Quran, Hafiz Imaduddin ibn Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala writes in the tafsir of Surah Yusuf, he says, Unzila ashraful kutub ala ashrafil rusul bi ashrafil lughat bi sifarati ashrafil malaika wa kana ibtida'u nuzulihi fi ashrafi biqa'il ard wa kana fi ashrafi shuhuris sana fakamula min kullil wujud. Allah revealed the most noble book, i.e. the Quran, through the most, upon the most noble messenger, i.e. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the best of all language, i.e. the Arabic language, through the medium of the best of all noble angels, i.e. Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, in the best of all places, i.e. Makkah Mukarrama, in the best of all month, i.e. the month of Ramadan. So it's been completed in every aspect, this Quran. So the problem we have, my brothers and sisters who are listening, we have completely neglected the Quran. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, whom we are hoping he will intercede, he will complain to Allah. وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. That Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam will say, oh my Lord, my people, my ummah, they have deserted the Quran. They have abandoned the Quran. They have distanced themselves from the Quran. Like mashallah, the scholar was speaking before me, that we have put the Qur'an, this Qur'an is for ourselves, not for our shelf. It's for ourselves, not for our shelf. The prophecy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, يُوشِكُ أَيَّأْتِيَ عَلَى النَّاسِ زَمَانِ لَا يَبْقَى مِنَ الْإِسْلَامِ إِلَّا إِسْمُهُ وَلَا يَبْقَى مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ إِلَّا رَسْمُهُ. A time will come upon the people, there will be nothing left of Islam but its name, nothing of the Qur'an but its scripts. So what's your name, my brother Abdullah? What's your name, Abdul Rahman? Sister, what's your name, Aisha? Sister, what's your name, Khadija? Do you perform salah? Do you recite the Qur'an? No. This is what's happening. We can see where they're living statistics. Today is a khatma Qur'an. We have come to the masjid, but the masjid is empty. On the day of Jummah, we have full, and we extend the masjid just for the sake of Jummah and Eid. But let us see our Fajr Salah. What is happening to us? So these programs that are taking place, we need to take a lesson from this. We have food here, take away the food. We need to take away the lessons. And the biggest problem is we're so busy, busy, busy. That word, we have completely abused the word. There was this very pious person called Qutubuddin Bakhtiyar Kaki Rahmatullahi. I want you to listen to this very attentively. I want your undivided attention, please, brothers and sisters. So this great scholar, this great sage of his age, very pious, waliullah, no question about it. So after he passed away, it was janaza, the funeral, everybody in thousands, they flocked for the janaza of this pious person. So just before the janaza, one person stood up and he said, the sheikh, before he passed away, he left this wasiyat, bequest. And he said, these are the conditions of the person who will be leading my janaza. The person who's going to be leading my janaza, he has to have four qualities in him. Four qualities. Number one, he has never missed a faraz salah with takbir ula. Not just faraz salah, with takbir ula. When was the last time you read five time prayers with takbir ula? Have you understood the first condition? We'll be failing the first one, leave alone the rest. So the first condition is the person who's going to lead my janaza, who's going to be the imam of my janaza salah, funeral prayer. Number one, he has to make sure that he has not missed a single salah with takbir ula. Number two, he hasn't missed any tahajjud salah. The night prayer, nocturnal prayer. Alaykum bi qiyamil layl fa innahu da'bu salihin. The hadith says, be constant, be consistent, punctual, steadfast in the nighttime prayer, because these are the qualities of the pious people. So second condition is that a person, he hasn't missed his tahajjud salah. Third one, he has not looked towards a ghair mahram with lust. Those strange one. Number four, which I always say is the hardest, that he has not missed the four rakats of sunnah of asr. Not the faraz. We're talking about the sunnah. And we know the category of that sunnah. It's not muakkada, it's ghair muakkada. It comes in the category of mustahab. We need to ask ourselves, when was the last time we read it? That's why in the hadith he mentioned, Rahimallah Imran Sallah Arba'an Qabla Al-Asr. Allah show mercy on that person who performs four rakat of sunnah before the four rakat of faraz. So basically, that person, four conditions, four requirements for that person. Number one, what did I say? Everybody awake? What was number one? Faraz namaz with takbir ula. Number two, tahajjud salah. Number three, he didn't look at a ghair mahram with lust. Number four, he didn't miss his four rakat of sunnah of asr. When these conditions were put forward, it was announced in the gathering of thousands. It was a pin drop silence. Nobody standing up. For a moment of time, everybody thought there will be no janaza. Because who's going to have these qualities? Not even one, leave alone four. Then suddenly one person, he advances towards the front. He inches forward. He's got a shawl over his head, tears in his eyes, crack in his voice. And he says, he points towards the coffin and he said, Hazrat, you have disgraced me. This was a secret between me and my Allah. But today, if I didn't disclose it, if I didn't expose that, if I didn't say it, then there will be no janaza. For this reason, I have to say, and I make you Allah witness and the people, that I have these four qualities. And the main important point here I like to say, who was this person? Who was this amazing, brilliant, prominent person? Allahu Akbar. He was the king of his time. He was the leader of his time. Sultan Shamsuddin Al-Tamish Rahmatullahi Alayhi. The reason why I'm mentioning this, my brother and my sister, is he was the king, he was the leader of a country. He had so many commitments, and he had the time to lead a pious life of this caliber, that he had the time to perform all his five-time prayers with Takbir-e-Ula. He had the time to be one-to-one with Allah at night time. He had this pious taqwa life, that he lived a life of high level of morality. He had that, subhanAllah, that even the mustahabbat, he carried out. Allahu Akbar. For us to make this excuse that we don't have time to perform salah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is going to be bringing the likes of Sultan Shamsuddin Al-Tamish Rahmatullah Alayhi. He had the time, he was the king. What did you do? What excuse? Allah will bring Uthman Ghani. If you say, I was too busy with my wealth, Allah will bring Abdurrahman bin Auf, Uthman Ghani radiyallahu ta'ala. Allah will bring, if you say, I had responsibility, I was the MP, I was the president, Allah will bring the likes of Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam, the likes of Sultan Shamsuddin Al-Tamish rahmatullahi alayhi. They were in charge of bigger places than you. They had the time to call me. Why didn't you have time? We got no excuse, my brother, my sister, we got no excuse at all. We need to make that change. Before it is too late, we need to make that change. In Urdu, the poet says, insan ghar badalta hai, libas badalta hai, rishte badalta hai, phir bhi pareshan rehta hai, kyunke khud nahi badalta. Did you understand this? Because we don't change ourselves, we change our house. No, there's a jinn there, there's black magic there, I'm going to change my house, I'm moving out. A lot of people come to us. They sell a house which they purchase for 300,000, 400,000 pounds just because you can hear some strange noise at night time. People will be rishte. No, my wife, she's evil, she's this, she's that. But the problem is we don't look within our own selves. This is the problem. So we need to make that change, and we need to make it now. Like in the English saying, they say, between the regret of yesterday and the hope of tomorrow is the opportunity of today. We've done all the mistakes, we've done all the sins, we've done all the vice and transgression and the evil. But today in this khatm Qur'an, du'as are accepted without a doubt. We're going to be doing du'a here, there's ulamas here, mashallah, there's huffaz here, there's people with white beard here, there are sisters here, mothers here, children here, du'as will be accepted. We need to make a change. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Allah doesn't change a nation until they don't change themselves. So we need to make that change, and we can't be procrastinating. إِيَّاكَ وَالتَّسْوِيفِ. The Hassan Abbas rahmatullah alayhi says, save yourself from procrastination. I will do it tomorrow, tomorrow, tomorrow never comes. My brother, my sister, tomorrow never comes. Each and every one of us, we need to make that change. Our daily life, how we waste our life. You know, every one of us, from morning till dusk, let us look into our life. Let us make a timetable. We are very disorganized people. On the weekend, like tomorrow is going to be Sunday, we're going to wake up at 11, 12 o'clock. This is the mentality we have made. That I'm going to miss my Fajr Salah, I'm going to wake up 11 o'clock, have a Sunday breakfast with my family, whatever, I'm going to eat out, and our Zohar is gone. No, no, we have to live a life of piety. We have to be Muslim, full-time Muslim. You know, the biggest problem we have is we are part-time Muslim. Jummah will come and that's it. From Jummah till Jummah, that's it. We think to ourselves, we've done a lot of things. And we please ourselves, we appease ourselves that we have fulfilled our responsibility. Ek molvi sahab aaye aur unhone bayan kiya gusse mein aakar kaha ke jo log namaz nahi padte wo gadhe hain. Out of anger he said it. Then he realized, no, I shouldn't have said this. So when he was leaving, the people stood outside with sticks. Because Maulvi sahab apne hame gade kaha. Because I didn't call you, I called those people who don't perform salah. Because hum to namaz nahi padte. So he starts scratching his head. And he said, aap log namaz nahi padte. Aap Eid ki namaz to padte hai nahi? Haan, Eid ki namaz padte. Aap log gade nahi hai. That's our mentality. We appease ourselves. MashaAllah, hum namazi hai. We have a nikah service. And there's a question there which says, are you practicing? And there's three boxes. Practicing, not practicing, trying to practice. 95% of the brothers and sisters will take practicing. On further interrogation, questioning, brother, what do you mean by practicing? So I did Jummah. I do Eid Namaz as well. In the month of Ramadan, I'll open the Qur'an and read a few paras. Akshay, mashallah, that's your practicing. That's your level of practicing. Sister, what do you mean by practicing? In the month of Ramadan, I buy the tasbih from the Islamic bookshops. And I do some tasbihat. I do put the dupatta down. That's our definition of practicing. And we appease ourselves. Alhamdulillah, hum sachche pakke musalman hain. Allahu Akbar, ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu dkhulu fis silmi kaffa. We need to enter Islam entirely. So today we need to go back home and we need to think for ourselves after this program that how are we going to transform our life? Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min shatatil amr. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has asked refuge that save me from being disorganized. We are the most disorganized people. We're supposed to be the most organized people. Inna salata kanat alal mu'minina kitaban mawquta. Every salah has been put over fixed time. And we are destroying salah, which is the first thing to be reckoned on the day of judgment. Awwalu ma yuhasabu bihil abdu yawm al-qiyamati as-salah. My brother, my sister, how important the salah is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even in battlefield, you can't miss your salah. وَإِذَا كُنْتَ فِيهِمْ فَأَقَمْتَ لَهُمُ الصَّلَاةَ فَلْتَكُنْ طَائِفَةٌ مِنْهُمْ مَعَكَ وَلْيَأْخُذُوا أَسْلِحَتَهُمْ فَإِذَا سَجَدُوا فَلْيَكُونُوا مِنْ وَرَائِكُمْ وَلْتَأْتِ طَائِفَةٌ أُخْرَى لَمْ يُصَلُّوا فَلْيُصَلُّوا مَعَكَ وَلْيَأْخُذُوا حِذْرَهُمْ أَسْلِحَتَهُمْ. Look at how beautifully in one full ruku Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the battlefield your life is in danger, you still can't miss your salah. You read namaz behind the imam, one rakat with the imam, after first rakat, second sajda finished, that jamaat, that group will go confront the enemies, and the jamaat that were combating the enemies, they will come and continue the salah with the imam. Allahu Akbar, but you can't make it qaza, you can't miss your salah. Woman, she is at the time labor pain, she's about to give birth to the child. At that time he's saying, namaz time comes, you read your namaz before the delivery of the child. You are drowning in the water, you can latch to a log and you can say takbir tahrima. Say that, then drown, but say takbir tahrima at least. This is how important it is. And this first pillar of Islam we have destroyed. What did Sayyidina Umar Faruq radiallahu ta'ala say? Inna ahamma umurikum indi as-salah. فَمَنْ حَفِظَهَا وَحَافَظَ عَلَيْهِ فَقَدْ حَفِظَ دِينَ وَمَنْ ضَيَّعَهَا فَهُوَ لِمَا سِوَى أَدْيَى. That indeed the most important thing in my eyes is salah. The person who preserved it, safeguarded it, he safeguarded the deen. If he destroys it, he will destroy the other pillars even more. So each and every one of us, my brother, today we make this intention. We become Hafiz of Qur'an. Becoming a Hafiz of Qur'an is very easy. To maintain it is very hard. That's why the hadith says, تَعَاهَدُ الْقُرْآنِ فَوَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ لَهُ أَشَدُّ تَفَسِّيًا مِنَ الْإِبِلِ فِي عُقُلِهَا. Preserve the Qur'an, take care of the Qur'an. By the one in whose hands my life is, it will go faster than a camel going away from his rope. So salah, in the same way, we need to preserve it. We just can't be lazy in carrying out our daily five-time prayers. Salah, if we don't perform it, it might end up is us in the fire of Jahannam. It's not something small. And I'm not saying it from my own self. In Surah Al-Muddathir, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions a conversation, a dialogue, which will take place between the people of Jannah and Jahannam. So in Surah Al-Muddathir, what it says is the people of Jannah will say, where is our friends? The ones that we interacted with, socialized with in our daily life, where are they? So if they're not in Jannah, they will be in Jahannam. They will peep into Jahannam, and the Quran speaks, مَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي سَقَرْ. What has taken you to Saqar? Saqar is the name of Jahannam. And what does the answer? What is the answer which will be given by the people of Jahannam? قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ. They will reply, we are not from those people who perform salah. What is that telling you, me and my brothers and sisters? If we don't perform salah, Allah forbid, Allah save us all, we might end up in the fire of Jahannam. My brother, my sister, we come to this gathering. MashaAllah, we have a lot of brothers and sisters. But we need to make this commitment. We can't delay it anymore. Hatta idha jaa ahadahumul maut, qala rabbi rji'un. When death approaches one of us and he says, Allah, return me back. Why? La'alli a'malu salihan fi ma tarak. So I could carry out good deeds. No. What does the Quran say? Kalla. Innaha kalimatun huwa qailuha. These are words that you are saying. Now you can't come back. Wamin wara'ihim barzakhun ila yawm yub'athun. Now you need to go towards your next journey. My brother, my sister, we are on a journey. We are in our second leg of our journey. We started our journey from alam arwah to alam dunya. From alam dunya, we're going to go into alam barzakh. At this moment of time, few of our brothers and sisters are in the alam arwah. Some are in alam dunya, like we are all in alam dunya. Many of our relatives have already reached alam barzakh. When the sur will be blown, وَنُفِقَ فِي السُّرْ فَإِذَاهُمْ مِنَ الْأَجْدَاثِ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَنْسِلُونَ. When the bugle, the trumpet will be blown by Israfil alayhi salatu wasalam, then what will happen is every one of us, they will have to go to alam akhirat, the fourth leg of our journey. So we are on a journey. We need to make sure that we fulfill our duty in this world before it is too late. Before it is too late. So on a daily basis, the main important thing, as I mentioned, is let us make a timetable. Don't be disorganized. In that timetable, we need to have, like the Imam Sahib before me, he was saying about at least reading some Quran every day. What does the hadith say? Man qara'a yasin fi sadrin nahar qudiyat hawa'iju. The person who recites Surah Yasin in the morning, all his needs are fulfilled. Do we start our day in that way? We are so pereshan. On a Monday morning, everybody is moaning and groaning. Moaning and groaning. Monday becomes a moan day. And they did a survey and they found the most depressed people on Monday. Because that's the first day of school, college, university, work, everything. Everybody's moaning and groaning, oh, we can't sleep enough. But I always say Monday is supposed to be the most happiest day. Monday was the day our beloved Prophet ﷺ came into this world. Monday is a day of fasting, a weekly fasting. We don't fast. You're moaning all the time. So let us start our day. You know, how do we start our day? Do we start with our Fajr Salah or do we just continue? We miss our Fajr every day. We need to do something. Imam Bukhari rahmatullah alayhi in the chapter of Kitab al-Tahajjud, he mentioned, يَعْقِدُ الشَّيْطَانُ عَلَىٰ قَافِيَةِ رَأْسِكُمْ إِذَا هُوَ نَامَ ثَلَاثَ وَقَدْ. When we go to sleep, shaitan puts three knots. يَدْرِبُ كُلَّ أُقْدَةٍ عَلَيْكَ لَيْلٌ تَوِيلٌ. And he said, لَيْلٌ تَوِيلٌ. Have a long night. فَرْقُدْ. Go to sleep. So my brother, we need to make this change in our life. How are we going to wake up in the morning? Are we going to wake up 9, 10, 11 o'clock? Are we going to wake up at 7 and go for Fajr Salah in Al-Hidayah? What are we going to do? Are we going to have the same kind of people here? Are we going to be all sleeping away? This is the question. Is there going to be a transformation? Are we going to go back? And that's it. Oh, we always hear lectures. You know, the father was giving a lecture to his son. The son wasn't listening attentively. So the father, after the talk, he said, did you understand? Oh, father, sorry. I forgot. So, what has happened? Because he's gone into one ear, he's come out with the other ear. So the father says, that's good, my son. A time will come, it will not even go through the first ear. And this is the time now. We'll be listening to lectures after lectures. Who doesn't know for us? Namaz is not for us. Everybody knows namaz is for us. Every one of us will know namaz is compulsory. But how many of us we are fulfilling that duty? So from today, what we need to do, we do sincere tawbah. And sincere tawbah means we reform, rectify, transform our life. There has to be a radical change. There has to be a complete change in our life before it is too late. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this opportunity. As I said, between the regret of yesterday and the opportunity and the hope of tomorrow is the opportunity of today. Let us make that change before it is too late. You know, before going to sleep, we are so busy with our mobile phones. What does the hadith say? Inna fil Qur'ani suratan salasuna aya. Shafa'at li rajulin hatta gufira lahu. There's a surah in the Qur'an which is of 30 verses. It will intercede for the person until he's forgiven. And that's Suratul Mulk. We are worried about our financial situation. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given us a prescription for our financial difficulty. What did he say? Man qara'a surat al-waqi'ati fi kulli laylatin lam tusibhu faqatun abadan. A person who recites surat al-waqi'ah every night, faqa, poverty, and he, poverty will not afflict that person ever. That's why it's called Suratul Ghina. It's only three rukus, only taking 5-10 minutes to read. We'll do all the other things. We have a daytime job, evening job, we have a weekend job, we have on the side of the cryptocurrency as well. Still, we're not satisfied. There's no contentment. Allahu Akbar, we need to get that divine contentment. لَيْسَ الْغِنَىٰ عَنْ كَثْرَةِ الْعَرَضِ وَلَكِنَّ الْغِنَىٰ بِنَ النَّفْسِ. This prosperity is not the abundant amount of wealth, it's the wealth of the heart. So my brother, my sister, we need to realize our life is very short. Like the Urdu poet says, عُمَرْ دَرَازْ مَانْكَرْ لَايَتِ چَارْ دِنْ دو عَرْزُ مَنْ كَتْ گَئِ دو انتظار مَنْ. We ask for a very long life. So Allah gave me that life, but I'm hoping I'm gonna do it tomorrow. And waiting, nothing happens. I know a person, he's visited at least 65 different countries, he told me himself. And I said, the first question I asked him is, have you performed your Hajj? Not yet, Mufti Sahib, not yet. Because when are you going to? Next year. For 15 years he's been saying that to me, still hasn't done it. Tomorrow, my brother, tomorrow never comes. And when tomorrow comes, it's too late. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu taqullah wal tanzur nafsum ma qaddamat lighad. Tomorrow is day of judgment. Innahum yarawnahu ba'ida wa narahu qariba. You think that this is far, it's very close. Sometimes Allah says, today is the day of judgment. Al yawma tujzawna adhabu. Not even tomorrow. Sayya'lamuna ghadam man al-kadhabul ashir. Sometimes he mentions tomorrow, you see. Sometimes he says today. The day of judgment is actually today. This thing is there for you. Are you ready for it? Yabna Adam innama anta ayyam fahidha dhahaba yawmun dhahaba ba'du. Hasan Basri Rahmatullah Ali says, you are made of few days, O son of Adam. When one day passes by, a part of you pass by. Today, when we stand up from here, we need to make a firm resolution that each and every one, like the previous scholars were saying, that we need to make that commitment. We're going to recite some part of the Quran. In the morning, start off with Surah Yasin. And we need to make sure we start off with our Fajr Salah, because man salla salata subhi fahuwa fi dhimmatillah. The person who performs the Fajr Salah is under the protection of Allah. Then read Surah Yasin, then start your day off. Then subhanAllah, before going to sleep, read Surah Mulk, read Surah Sajda. This will safeguard us from the any punishment of the grave. Read Surah Waqia, it will give us financial stability. In that way, subhanAllah, for the Hafiz of Quran, this Quran has to be preserved in the heart all the time. Shaykh al-Hadith Mullah Muhammad Zakariya Samnawar Allah Marqadahu, he says, for a Hafiz of Quran, it should be three juz. For a non-Hafiz, it should be one juz. So each one, that's why he says, janam rog hai. We need to keep that, it's a lifelong. To become a Hafiz is easy, to preserve it is the hardest. We put all our time, a Hafiz for 3, 4, 5 years, day and night is reading. After he becomes a Hafiz, so negligent, he's so careless, he doesn't even put half an hour in. What kind of Hafiz are we? So each and every one of us, for Hafiz the Quran, this is what we need to do. Those who are Hafiz the Quran, three paras. If you can't, at least one juz. In that way, we can move forward. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the true understanding of the Quran. I like to congratulate Brother Shahid and the family, mashallah, and the son who has become a Hafiz Quran, mashallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve the Quran in his heart. I need to go to the next Khatm Quran, inshallah ta'ala. That's why I'm finishing off here. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our gathering and all our scholars who have come to lecture and address the audience. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept their speeches as well and accept Al-Hidayah for the propagation of deen and the ta'aleem and tarbiyah in this place. Wa akhiru da'wan alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.